you look at the large cloud providers, their data centers are really in North America and Europe, almost entirely, and we're leaving behind the rest of the world. So if I can produce technology that puts the power of everything that we have and that we take for granted into the palm of everyone's hand, most people have a phone, not a computer, right? And it doesn't rely on there being a large single centralized provider somewhere, then we can bring everyone along with us, having more diversity in tools and approaches, and for more contexts, benefits literally everybody. So I want to see what the other, 4 billion people on the planet are going to produce in the next 10 years. My name is Brooklyn Zelenka. I'm the co-founder and CTO at Fission. We're building accessible software for everyone. Fission's building a decentralized app stack, tools and protocols that make it much easier to build applications, especially ones that respect user privacy and user agency, but also just to make it easier to build apps in general. The parts of the problem that we're working on are identity, data, and compute. This is really everything you need to build an application, but today is locked inside of providers like AWS or Google or Microsoft. What we've always wanted to get to is the compute part, right? That's the thing that I'm really passionate about. To do compute, you need to have some data to compute over. And to do data in production, you need to do identity or at least access control of some kind. I might have some data, but I don't want everybody else to be able to read it, right? We've produced a bunch of standards and specs that are getting picked up inside of the PLN and outside of as well, like UCAN, which is a decentralized auth protocol. The reason that we started the company, we discovered that for people in Web3, all of the classic Web2 stuff was very foreign and new and different. My co-founder and I have a long history in web development and open source and all these things that a lot of people in Web3 are now having to learn because you have to get things in front of users, you have to build a website, you have to run a server, all of this stuff. Then for Web2 developers, what if we can make it easy for both groups? We thought surely this will take us 6 months, and here we are 3 years later. I dropped out of a music theory program in 2005, worked as a graphic designer for a while and ended up in tech, found that I really enjoyed VMs, compilers, and distributed systems. And at one point, my now co-founder Boris asked if I wanted to lead the R&D effort at a company he had previously started. And I said, sure, that sounds interesting. Ended up as an Ethereum core developer for a little bit. And then after being in that space for a while and realizing that this stuff is really hard for basically everybody, thought, well, what if we could apply all of these tools and techniques to everybody else's problems? And decided to start a company around that. It is so, so important to have partners and advisors in the space that really understand the state that things are currently in. Things are early, it's exciting. There's a lot of low-hanging fruit to go and tackle, but you can't take existing things and just plug them together, right? We're starting to get to that point now, but having teams like all the wonderful people at Protocol Labs or in the PLN generally, that we can pick their brains and say like, hey, what do you have and what do you have and what have you learned? Is so much better than being lost and trying to figure things out ourselves. So the Protocol Labs Network, PLN, is an acknowledgement that we have a pipeline from research through product. A giant chasm in the middle of things that tend to not get funded, typically, and that are absolutely crucial to that pipeline, but are underinvested in. Those are really hard problems, taking things from Genesis to all the way out to users. And often groups will focus on one part of it, but not the whole thing. It's especially difficult because it requires experts across a large number of fields. At Fission, we wouldn't be able to do what we do, or at least it would be significantly more difficult if we didn't have access to the PLN. We can make use of all of the resources that are available across the network through all the different teams building all these different products, and then also influence their roadmaps. So it's not that we're individual companies that are, potentially competing with each other. It's that we're additive and we're more together than we are apart. If you look at some of the real success stories for things that are like this, they have a Slack for the group, and they, you know, they'll have advisors and help, but not in the same way where it is completely blurred between, you know, Fission and Number Zero are collaborating on work, or us and DAG House, or even that Protocol Labs is nucleating teams out of what was inside of Protocol Labs and now coming out and taking it literally from a, you know, prototype project into something that's going to be in the real world, and connecting them to us directly to say, what are the things that we need so that we don't need to build them? This system of networked orgs is basically trying to find ways that we can have higher leverage on all of the brains in the room, and I think that's amazing. So the way we're pushing humanity forward is by equipping everyone with the tools to build software, which is an extremely powerful tool in and of itself, right? So that they can build small businesses or build tools for themselves or for their communities. There's this saying, software is eating the world. And we think it hasn't even started eating the world yet. But in order for that to be actually true for everyone, we have to radically lower the barrier of entry so that it doesn't take a huge amount of capital and a huge amount of effort to get involved. We want to make it so that anyone can build, deploy, maintain software. Or maybe another way of saying it is, how do I want to put a ding in the universe? How will I put a ding in the universe? The hope really is that I can just leave things better than I found them. Going from music to tech was literally life-changing, and wanting to enable that for lots of other people, and just lowering the bar, making it just really easy for people to get involved and to have the just benefit of the quality of life improvement that I had, and enabling that for literally, hopefully, billions of other people would be amazing.